In this video, we will look at how to create a character's animation transition and blending. Yui Chan, who specially appeared in the How to Switch Weapon video, will be reused as the main character of today's tutorial. Yui Chan has completed rigging before being imported into Unity, and her rig setup is set to humanoid. She is not pretty without color, so I'm going to make a material. This time, I will apply a custom shader that I made specially. We'll cover custom shaders later. Next, I will create an animator to play animations for Yui Chan. In today's example, I'm going to use animations of idle state and running state. Both animations are using loop time and the rest of the settings are as follows. Please note that there is a difference depending on the animation creation environment and the export method. Now let's move both animations to the animator. Conditions are required for the transition between these two animations. First, let's create a transition between the two animations. In this video, there are only transitions between the two animations, so I will create a bool parameter. If the bool parameter is true, I will make the running animation play, and vice versa. After applying the animator to the character, let's check it out. By alternating the parameters true and false, you can see that the animation is switched. However, the transition between the two animations does not occur immediately, so if the character stops while moving, the transition of the animation will appear to be delayed. Uncheck has exit time so that the animation transition takes place immediately. This makes it possible to switch between different animations while the animation is playing. It has been confirmed that the transition of the animation occurs immediately. Now it's time to apply the attack animation. Attack animation should be possible while standing and while moving. It is difficult to play the attack animation on a layer with walking and running animations, so let's create a separate layer. Attack animation only has arms and back movements. In particular, please note that the attack motion should not have the animation keys of the hips and legs for blending with other animations. Apply the attack animation to the upper layer. If this is the case, the attack animation plays at the start of the game, so you need to make it a state that does nothing. Create an empty state and set it to the set as layer default state so that this is executed first. Similarly, let's create transitions for the switching between the two animations. The condition for the attack seem appropriate to use the trigger. Now that we have created the trigger parameter, let's apply it to the condition. For this transition, I will also uncheck has exit time so that the attack animation plays immediately. After the attack is over, I won't set a condition to automatically do nothing. I want to play the attack animation, but nothing happens. Maybe something is missing. If you look at each layer, you can see that there is a gear icon. Let's go through the options by clicking on the gear button on the upper layer. Weight is a function that adjusts the animation strength of the layer. Closer to 0 makes the animation in the layer move less, and close to 1 plays the full animation. We want the attack animation to play completely, so let's set it to 1. Then select additive for the blending option so that it plays simultaneously with other animations. Now, let's see if all the animations are working fine. You can see that the attack animation plays well while running. Attack animation is also active while idle animation is playing. That's all for today's video, and next we'll look at how to control move and attack by script. Thank you, see you next time.